to the, I want to return to the issue of the fairing meaningful contribution, but in particular the role of insurers. There was some concern before about the impact on a charitable organisation's finances if it made a contribution but its insurer wasn't. Have you got any clearer understanding about what the attitude of the insurance industry is going to be to this?
Mr Rennie is absolutely correct that there's an interplay between the financial sustainability of, let's call them, well, I'll call them providers, and the application of fair and meaningful contributions, because what we acknowledged in the bill, and we actually, when we amended the bill during its passage, was to recognise the fundamental vulnerability that Mr Rennie raises, that organisations potentially could be rendered financially unsustainable by the consequences of this scheme on the basis of payments required in the 2020s for events that could have taken place in the 1970s. So that issue has been reconciled by the terms of the bill and by the application of the fair and meaningful principles. There's then, but what lies behind that in some circumstances will be the role of insurers. And there isn't a generic position on instance of insurance companies. It will depend very much on the arrangements and dialogue between providers and insurance companies. So the government's dialogue is with providers, and it's then for providers to be making their judgments based on their dialogue with their insurers about what is the nature of that financial relationship. But fundamentally, we will be making a judgment based on an assessment of the dialogue with providers as to their financial sustainability as part of arriving at what we consider to be fair and meaningful contributions.
You probably won't want to answer this because I suspect this is subject to the negotiations, but for confidence for some of the provider or sort of the charitable organisations, if their insurance company wasn't contributing and it did threaten the viability of an otherwise good organisation, would your system be able to flex to reflect the fact that the insurer wasn't paying? Or is that something that's subject? Is that clear?
I think the best way to explain that is probably to reinforce what I said in Parliament during the passage of the bill, that I don't want to see organisations who are making substantial contributions to the delivery of good purposes in our society today to be rendered unsustainable because of failures of the past, and that is material to the discussions that we undertake. But equally, we do believe that providers and insurance companies, well, providers and also by their actions their insurance companies, need to engage substantively in the discussions that are being taken forward by my officials to secure fair and meaningful contributions.
Okay, that's fine.